Featuring Professor Ken and Reek in the Lion's Den.
When a hooker plays a trick, you know, there's a lot of instances that this plays out in today's time, you know, one of them being the little young rapper that got, you know, $500,000 worth of his jewelry lifted from two females that were, you know, doing the girlfriend experience. I mean, how does this type of situation go down?
Well, you know, Reek, that's been my whole career. You know, one of the things that, you know, a guy that's in the game, you know, a professional guy, you know, we start off, you know, we don't have no game. So the first thing we tell the broad is, hey, look, we bought there, you know, here's some condoms, you know, go flip a couple of tricks, whatever. And then, you know, the broad might call and say, daddy, this guy got $100,000 in the briefcase. Naturally, you know what I mean? You try to separate that trick from the briefcase and you tell us, look, here, this is what you do. Act like you go in the bathroom or tell us you go in the bathroom. When you go in the bathroom, you snatch the briefcase and you run. Or, you know, some guys even go more technical than that. You know, a lot of guys, you know, back in the early 70s and the 80s and some parts of the 90s, and some guys still try it today, they used to use drops of Visine. They put some Visine in a drink and the trick would go to sleep. When the trick would go to sleep, the chicks, you know what I'm saying, they would ram through the house, fill his Rolex, fill his jewelry, whatever, you know, and vacate, you know, bag it home and take it home to their daddy. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, even if you look at the movie, The Mat, if you notice that the trick was in there, he was dating the bra, and then the other bra was dating him, then she took his pants, and she ran out the hotel with his pants.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So prostitutes been playing on tricks since the beginning of time. You know what I'm saying? It's just that, you know, most tricks, you know what I'm saying? They know better. They leave their watch at the crib, or they leave their money at the crib. They only take out the money that they trying to spend. But the problem is, when you know you get somebody from another country or somebody who is their first rodeo, they don't know that these broads, they train to go and they slick as hell. They make you feel like they love you. They make them feel like they really down with you, make you feel real comfortable. If they don't put you to sleep with some type of chemical, then what they're going to do, they're going to send you in the bathroom. As soon as you go in that bathroom, they're going to run out that door with that watch or those pants. Another trick, you know, that a lot of chicks use, you know what I'm saying, separate the trick, you know, from his money is, you know, they'll get a hotel. And then in the hotel, they'll put some toilet paper in the door and they'll leave the door jammed. So while they be screaming and moaning and acting like you're really doing your thing, even if you ain't got but a 3-inch penis, you know what I'm saying, they acting like you're doing, you're killing me. Oh, they moaning and groaning. While they're moaning and groaning, the friends sneak up in there and go in the pockets. And then slide right back off and they steal the wallet. You know, it's just so many ways. And then you got some chicks, you know, they just good with their hands. And they grab a trick by the penis. You know, while they talking to him in the car, they grab him until he get hard. As soon as he get hard, they go into his pocket with the other hand. You know, or, you know, I done seen, you know, bras, you know, go in the clubs, the square clubs and the strip clubs, get to talking to a guy buying them a drink. They take the razor blade and they cut his pocket right by the money. You know what I'm saying? And the money fall out. And while the money fall out, her wife-in-law or her girlfriend, she picks up the money off the floor while she distracted them. You know, or they could cut the back of their pocket with a razor and go in the razor and take the wallet. So it's a thousand ways for a trick to get played. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And it's been going on since the beginning of time. You know, and, you know, most guys, you know, the old school guys, they say, man, I read it from the flat back and for mine, but, you know, a lot of these new school guys, man, hey, man, to them, it's just another hustle.
Most
24/7.